Greetings, fellow links. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. Right now, we are about to respond to Minisera's voice in our head. And, yeah, we have already done this. It hasn't really been recorded in our log, but Minisera essentially told us to come see her in Castle Shedungent. Shedungent, because the Totem of Tiber Septim found a new owner of Tiber Septim's bloodline, and this is essentially going to send us towards the very, very final quest of this entire game. I don't know whether I can still play the game afterwards or not, or whether we'll just have to, you know, load up an old save, but Castle Shedungent? There is none? Castle Shedungent? What, really? Yeah, there is a place called Shedungent, but not Castle Shedungent, so I guess that was my fault. Anyway, I have 3,000 gold, which is dead weight at this time, point in time anyway. Now we can equip ourselves. I would actually like to switch over to my sword at this point. I took all of my weapons out of my bag and I'm over encumbered at this point, meaning that I cannot really pick up anything else that I find in the dungeon. But I'm not really looking to pick up anything either. Talking to Nulfaga should not be that big of an issue. We just go in, talk to her, get out, that's it. I mean, there would be a couple of gargoyles here, so that's a different thing. Shut up, put me to freeze. Oh, no gargoyles this time around. Just human enemies. Like the first time. Sorcerer died. And you too. Backstabs on both. Alright, so this is probably the only time we're going to get to save before a dungeon, so might as well go ahead and make the most of it. I'm going to make a pre-dungeon save right here. Because this sequence will trigger, you know, the our journey into Aetherius. Only crowned heads will hold the totem true. First is one who killed but did not kill another. Second is one who is too devoured by its young. Third is one who made one slave and many free. Fourth and fifth are two who compete for mud. Sixth is one who brings a home to the homeless. Seventh is one who lords all but does not lord at all. I do not know who of these seven is most worthy of the power. For too long I have let my passions make me mad. Sometimes the fate of a world hang on the decision of one person. You have chosen who will command Great Numidium. You bear the burden for the consequences. Damn. I wonder who she's talking about with all of these, you know, seven eligible folk right here. One who killed but did not kill another. It's as cryptic as, you know, her personality, to be honest. Nulfaga. I send you now to the Mantellan Crux, a safeguarded prison of the Mantella. Look for a green jewel of unusual size. Merely touch the Mantella and it is freed. You will be transported back to my side. Ah, that's nice. So we can continue adventuring after this. Alright, here goes nothing. The final quest, I wonder how difficult it's gonna be. Right then. So, starting off. Wait, why am I not getting the levitate spell? That's strange. I just reloaded this level and I'm not getting any levitate spell. Excuse me? Do I have to like touch it at a specific... Okay, so I have to keep touching it. Okay, so I guess it's not a one-time use thing. It's like a multiple use thing. I just need to keep touching it as well. Alright, so there's this one here for Sardis. We flip this, which should unlock the one at the very base of this. At the base of this one, I mean. I don't know. Okay, there's a frost stage around there. Time to go pop in a potion of resist frost. I mean, I am a Nord, so I already have a genetic immunity to frost, but still. Okay. time to flip this switch. Sorry, just this door, this door, and this door. And hopefully that would have unlocked. We don't want to go down those ones there. Let's call this elevator down, and I'll go back up and I'll wait to get another levitate cast on me, because I don't know when this is gonna wear off, and I don't want to be standing in the middle. I want to preserve my potions for as much as possible. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back up, slay that data lord that's in that cranny there, this crevice here. From the looks of it, it has been unlocked. How strange. No, it is not. Come on. Do I really need to use a spell on you? Okay, this is gonna happen now. Yeah. Leaping cloth amulet, paralysis, undeniable access. Ah yes, right here. Use. Is it like a touch range spell then? Because it did not damage him at all, so I guess I can use the shield right here. Yeah, good. Come here. Excuse me. I didn't realize you can use shock spells as well. Good. Good on you. You dead. You finally died. There's not really seem to be anything of value in this room either, so we're just gonna let this room be and go back up. And we're gonna save here, because otherwise there's a tendency that you might fall down. Okay, that works. And then I'm gonna rest here. I'm fully healed. And then I'm gonna save here. Alright. Time to keep touching you until we get levitation again. Fine. Thank you. Took you long enough, but thank you. So what we need to do is now we need to go down to this one, because there was another lever down there. I don't know what that lever does, but it does something. There's another similar cranny down here that we need to get into and, well, essentially just flip the lever. That's what we need to do. Now where's the cranny is what I'm trying to figure right here. No enemies inside here, just this lever here. And that is as much as I figured out until the time that I lost my potion of levitations. And right now is the time when I figured out that you can actually keep touching the statue and get levitate indefinitely. I did not know that before. Now this should be, yeah, that one right there. I think that one is unbarred now? No, yes it is. Yes, amazing. Apparently I'm still levitating even though it does not tell me that I have levitation cast on me. Okay. We can climb or we can just levitate to the top. I don't know how long this is gonna last, but... Okay, this is about to die. Cool. You would have needed a levitate spell to get up here. I'm just gonna go ahead and save in the emergency slot here. What now, I wonder? Which way? Left? Okay. Let's try going left. Let's see what this holds for us. If anything at all. Harpies. A couple of them. I mean, technically, this is considered a harpy's nest, so... Not a surprise that there are harpies. So, by the way, I actually got the Warlock's Ring here. And, well, it basically casts Shalero's Mirror, Heal, and Feet of Nostorgo. So this is an incredibly overpowered thing to use. And to have, to be honest. Instead of going there, let's try going this way first. I'll save here. Upstairs, okay. That's a seducer. Seducer is dead. Like, of all things, the Seducer... Oh yeah, I'm overweight anyway. My carrying capacity is 112. But I've got like 121. I'm carrying 121 weight right now, even though my carrying capacity is 112. Excuse me. Yeah, these guys like fuck you up. These guys like completely fuck you up. Excuse me. Wow. Okay, healing. Good thing I have got healing. Wow. Holy shit. These guys fuck you up. I think this might just be the way to go because... Well... There are magical bars over there, so... I'm guessing this is the way to go. I was just looking for any more Daedric artifacts at this point. Okay, now I wonder... what this does. Whether this actually unlocks anything or not. And whether I need to flip this back up to unlock the last one. Yes, I do. The puzzles in this game can be quite cryptic. Let me just save here. Like, re-update the save because, well, we have made progress. And it would suck if a Daedra Lord just comes and one-shots us, so yeah. Well, nothing here, except for this one last... What is this? Orc strength. Should we just go ahead and use it? Might as well. We could use the strength boost. I don't know what this does, but hopefully it unlocks the last thing up top on the other end. The unlocks the bars. The door unlocks the last door there. And I do believe this is where we go. I'm just gonna equip a potion of slow falling. Because I'm not sure. I don't think I can. Rest once I'm down there because of enemies. And let me pop in the potion of levitation. And we're gonna go across to where that other one is. No, this is the one that we came out of. The other one should be in this direction here. The cool thing about this place is that... now, this might be because of the technical limitations of the game, but... You can actually... Wait, where... Okay, let's get down here first. We should be able to see the other one from here. Where is the other one? There's supposed to be one more somewhere here. Okay, we flip this. Where is that? Oh, like seriously, where is it? I can't find it anymore. That's the one we came out of. Is it somewhere here? Oh yes, yes, here it is. Unless that is one that came out of. I hope it is not. Wait, did that? No. Okay, it's right here. No, I think this is the one that we came out of. No, it's not actually. Let me go ahead and save here then. Hold up. Resist shock. Resist fire. And what else? Yeah, I don't think we need anything. Die. No Torgo! It's an upside down room, okay. And this Oh, this... No, this is just a chair. Why did I come here? Yeah, why did I come here? For no reason, apparently. There's nothing here, right? Let me just open the map up and check once. Does not seem to be anything else here. Except for... Well, this place in the Aetherius, there's nothing else there. And there was nothing else down below, so I'm guessing that the only place that is worth anything, that has anything worth, you know. Let me just try touching this. Any of these tables, perhaps? No, I don't think so. There's nothing here. So, yeah, I suppose, except for this torch. Why is it upside down? Yeah, this torch is the only thing that is upside down. The rest of the room is like... If the rest of the room was right side up, this torch is the only thing that's upside down, is what I'm trying to say. Now, we can... We should probably pop in a potion of levitation. We would have two left at the end of it, and let's hope that that is enough. I mean, as long as we can make it to the central island, we can just cast Levitate on ourselves infinitely. Levitation, 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 levitation. Yes, right here. Thank you. And, yeah, that... Somewhere in the middle is where we're trying to go here. We already killed the Daedra Lord there, but I don't know whether it actually has something there or not. Should be right about here. Yes, it has been unlocked now, although I wonder why. Why is honestly the question. What is the point of having this unlocked? It does not tell me anything, to be honest. I can't even see my own character. It says that is... the dungeon entrance, but you can't exactly leave until you find the Mantella. Oh, that was a teleporter, right? Amazing. Okay, that's in progress. Or so I would suppose. Might as well just... Of course, I can't loiter here because enemies are around. That's the only part that I can see. No, that's just the texture of the wall, not exactly anything else. There's something up there, we might as well check it out, I suppose. Oh wait, this is a pyramid. From the looks of it. It's an ancient lich that immediately paralyzes me. Amazing. Tall boots. Where did the tall boots go? Unrestrainable tall boots. But I might as well go ahead and use like a potion of resist shock. You know what? Might as well. That guy's dead. I also have Feat of Notorgo cast on me, so that is pretty good, so I would think. But there's like a trapdoor right here. And, yeah, what? Is there anything else down there? Not from the looks of it, no. I guess it's like another one of those puzzles where you need to. The levitation is wearing off, which is good. I'm just gonna rest here until fully healed, because, well, I can. And probably should not have saved it. Probably should have saved in like a new slot instead. But yeah, I guess one of the disadvantages of having Feet of Notorgo is the fact that you tend to jump, or like a high speed is that you tend to jump a little too far. And this is the only thing I can see where we go anywhere, so let's go down, I suppose. I don't know why it's making that sound, or whether or not it is even supposed to make that sound, but let's say... Yeah, that's probably like a way back up. Bye! It was nice seeing you, but why am I stuck into this wall here? Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Now I understand why they keep suggesting the levitate spell for this. Because, well, this game just isn't platforming friendly. You're essentially making things far more difficult on yourself by not levitating. I can hear a harpy. And that sounded like pig squealing. There's a gate and stuff in there. Hi there. I'm just gonna ignore you. This takes me like a floor lower, and let me just go and save here. There's a lich up ahead, so I'm just gonna pre-pop a potion of resist shock, and yep, that's why I saved it. I don't want to pointlessly waste all my potions of levitation sword, because I only had 4. At this point, I have 2. So yeah. I'm paralyzed. Amazing. Unrestrainable tall boots. Where are we? Right here. Safe. This game is not platforming friendly. Very clunky platforming mechanics. We're apparently just going down and down and down. That's all we're doing. This apparently takes us up. I think those guys were just there to mess with us. We didn't really need to take them out. Because this is apparently taking us elsewhere. I don't know where it will take us, but it is taking us somewhere. Maybe it'll take us back to the pyramid and it'll somehow be open now? I suppose that's what it is doing, but okay. I mean, it's not stopping, so that's one thing. Oh, okay. Alright. But there's like this random lamp here that we can touch. It apparently does something, because maybe it'll give us levitation again, I don't know. Wait, maybe it unlocked that room. I'm levitating. Yeah, it does give us levitation, in fact. Except I don't know what to do with this levitation, because, well, I just wish I could levitate down faster. Although this levitation spell seems to last for a bit, so that's one thing. I think this is the part with the vampires. Let me pop in a potion of resist shock. And this as well, a shield. Potion of resist shock. Not a ruby of shocking, but potion of resist shock. Resist frost, resist fire. Resist frost, resist shock. Right here. And might as well use the blazing wrap of fireballs. Where is it? Yeah, right here. Come on then. Like, I saw the doors here, and I immediately thought to myself, yeah, it is most likely. Vampire died. Where's the vampire ancient? Unfuck that guy up. Okay, going through this did nothing. But there are like a bunch of graves here that we can... that we probably have to search through. This is skull there. Honestly, I would like to save before I touch anything. Nothing. This grave. It makes a sound. Here lies the spirit of benefactor, though his body still guards the way. Okay. That just makes a sound. I don't know where else we can go, to be honest. There was that one place in the... down below, you know? Beneath this pyramid. Maybe we can go there. Maybe we can go there and check what to do next. I'm going to try that. No, load. If it's too difficult to do this way, I might as well just go ahead and try to do it by... You're gonna show up right this time around, huh? You know what? Okay. This is gonna happen. First of all, I'm gonna use this. And secondly, I'm gonna use the industry and the tall boots. Thirdly, I'm gonna use this. Ooh, there are more? I thought I slew you all. Apparently not. Apparently not. Nothing of use for me. Okay. I'm just gonna save here. Like, rest here. And then I'm gonna save. Again. Don't know how that happened, but... well, it did. Maybe we can make it to this one. Yes, we did. We made it to that one. Okay, this is now open. Oh wait, there's another one here. I bet this one unlocks the pyramid. I'm gonna resave here. And... good thing I saved there. platforming in this game, I swear. Did that respawn the vampire somehow? Apparently it did. I guess that is a bug. I mean, at this point we can just pop in a potion of levitation and go all the way up, but... you know what? Yeah, let's just take the long way around. I don't want to waste my time doing all this. All this platforming, I mean. Ah, yes. Here it is. Time for us to head back down. And... we go here, and here, and here, and here. And... let me save you. Good thing I saved there. This should call down that last thing that got us all the way down, and it should have unlocked the top of the pyramid now. I mean, thus far I'm liking this dungeon. It is a little slow, but it is also a very puzzle-focused dungeon, so yeah. Thus far, I am quite liking it. That's probably the sound of the gargoyle trying to come to us. Although, I'm pretty sure gargoyles can fly, so I don't know why that thing is not flying at us. And this thing is gonna take its time coming down because, well, it's a long elevator ride. We can't see it, but yeah, it's gonna take its time coming down. Can't really do much except for wait here because, well, actually, oh, it's here. I was about to say that if you rest, the elevator does not exactly, you know, or even if you pause the game or something, the elevator does not exactly stop moving, so you might as well just exploit that fact. But looks like we didn't need to. Now to ride all the way back up. Benefactor, was it? I feel like it might be one of those puzzles like from the Colosseum, wherein they told us to name the maker of the place. No way we're making this jump, but after we get up there, pretty sure we can probably just levitate down. But the trapdoor is still not open. Oh, so what do we have to do then? Trapdoor should have been open by now. Are we doing something wrong? Let's just... I'll save here. And... Well, that was nice of you. Let's follow this wall until we... like... find something of value. If even there is something of value here. I cannot see anything here, to be honest. But at least doing it this way will map out the entire space for us, which is practically what we need. Oh, look, there is a room there. How did we miss that? Well, that's just half a yard, to be honest. Okay, I'll save here. And what are we gonna do now? There are like a couple of enemies here already. These are honestly just dungeon decorations, we can't exactly loot them. This is the first time I've seen this sprite, this guy who does not seem to be doing anything. Maybe we can... I guard the way. Speak only my name and I shall grant you passage. Was it the name on the grave, benefactor? Okay, I suppose it was. And nothing else opens up for us, so I suppose we go back. I wonder what would have happened if we had spoken the wrong name to him. Did he open the pyramid for us then? Curious, we need to know. Now here's the thing, I can't make it to anything without... actually I can, I suppose. I think I can. Oh yeah, I could. And is the trapdoor open there? I think it is. Yes, it is, it is, it is. Amazing. Come on. Give me levitate. I'm not gonna hurt you, just give me levitate. That's all I want. Levitate, come on, levitate. Yeah, finally, thank you. It's difficult to tell when this game does what, to be honest. It seems like... it's still... yeah, we... oh, okay. I was about to say, the trapdoor's open, but it still seems sealed. Excuse me? I feel drained, that's definitely a... where is it? Warlock's ring? Fine, might as well go and use it. Excuse me, I want to kill you. Save as a spell made. Boots of paralysis, toxic. I just want to heal up for the most part. Warlock's ring. What about this other guy? Who else is attacking me? I cannot tell, to be honest. Might as well use the Warlock's ring once more. And along with that, let's just go ahead and pop in a potion of resist shock. Do we have a potion of resist shock? No, just resist fire for now. Resist shock, resist shock, resist shock. Right here. Well, people stopped shocking me, so I'm guessing that's good. Can I rest here? I cannot sleep now? Why is that? Oh, can I sleep now? Yeah, probably. Cool. Even though I can't hear enemies down there, I'm glad that I can sleep. I'll just go and update the save. I don't wanna save over the other slot. Just a second there. Yeah. That was sort of messing with me. And there is seemingly another elevator here. Guarded by a trapdoor. I wonder whether we got all those trapdoors or not. I guess. A seductress. A data seducer, rather. Is as they call it. Should I save here? I guess. Does not hurt, I suppose. That, I suppose, is a elevator? I'm guessing we need to go down inside of the pyramid as far as possible to get anywhere. I mean, this entire dungeon crawl has been very confusing to me. I mean, they sort of went overboard with the puzzles, in my opinion. I mean, if they had any clues and stuff, that would have been great, but most of it is just exploring and then you find like a random puzzle piece. And that's that. And we're still going down. I wonder where it will lead us. Okay. Long ride down. I suppose we can take this ride to the very bottom. Don't know what's gonna come out of it though, but yeah, I suppose we can take this ride to the very bottom. I have a feeling that I am in some place that I'm not supposed to be. But then again, this is practically Aetherius, so yeah, it's not supposed to be meant for man armor. Just Aetra and Daedra. A place where every step entails betrayal. Just a skeleton. Am I glad to see a skeleton here? Skelly. Of course, right, I forgot I can't pick up any more items. And a harpy! I wonder if I'm even going the right way, if I'm facing all of these enemies. I guess we'll find out soon. There are two rooms here. This room seems grandiose. Huh. Well, we are in another part of the puzzle right here. And this is a loot room, in case you want to restock up and stuff. Okay. Nothing that I can carry here. It shows weapons there, but we don't... Oh, for a second I thought that the... It disappeared, like the door disappeared, but no, it's there. And this is another room of Aetherius, room full of Aetherius, like a room full of space. There's something down there. Interesting. And there are two elevators that we can take to go down to their respective places, I suppose. I just wish they would make this game like non-spellcaster friendly, like especially this level. If I did not have potions, I would not have been able to complete this level. Oh well. This, unfortunately, is where I leave things today because of lack of time. But when we come back, we will be picking things up from here. So, yeah, take care. See you guys soon. Okay, so I think it was this one. Yeah. Can I not? Do I really have to be on the precipice to be toggling this lever here? Seemingly, I do. Seemingly, I do. So yeah, that apparently opened something up, and it sounded super close, so I'm guessing maybe it's that magically held door. But the solution to this part can't be that easy, right? I mean, pretty sure there's like much more to it than just that. Outer space comes in walls. I suppose we are stuck inside like a quark or something. like a dimension, an ember of creation, if you will. I mean, that's the only way the limitations of this game can canonically make sense. The fact that Aetherius has rooms for you to access. Okay. Resist, what was it again? Frost. And I'm gonna use the ring which returns your damage to you. Well, actually, the damage of your spells to you. Frost Aetra died. And yeah, of course, this guy still has the same loot though, I wonder why. And the first one was this. Excuse me, thank you. Yes, like getting out of these rooms is somewhat of a headache. Of course. Let me just go ahead and wear the wit one. Become a little witty. Perhaps I can change the look of this. Seemingly I can. I like the last one best. Let's go ahead and equip this. And let me save you. Otherwise there's a high probability I might eat myself off into, you know, the Aetherius again. And this was the magically held door. I don't know what's behind this, but something might just be behind it. Something of value, I mean. Because why would these two mechanisms unlock at them? Unless we accidentally chanced. Don't know why I'm saving here at this point, but oh well. Since we have the opportunity, might as well, right? There's also so many of these pathways. Okay, this blue thing here, it's like a giant crystal. This teleported us somewhere. And I can only hope that this is in fact the correct path for us to go. I'm gonna save you. Probably should not have done that, but okay. I wonder if this is gonna be one of those areas where we need to like go all over the place and just save versus spell made. Okay, resist fire and resist shock. You know what? This is happening. I'm gonna use two things here. Of course, I can't use that. I'm gonna use this first. And then I'm gonna equip this here sword. Might not be as powerful as... Well, might not be as damaging as the other sword, but... Is that an orc? These are all orcs. I wonder why there are so many orcs here. There's like this trapdoor here. I'm not even checking them because, well, I know for sure that I cannot pick up anything that they have to offer unless it is by means of dropping all my gold. But I wonder what orcs are doing here. Ooh, no, these look like nice greaves. Although, I have the exact same ones. Round shield. It's sad that shields don't exactly have a... aren't exactly made of any special metals in this game. I often wonder if I need to touch any of these statues, but... Oh well. I'm just gonna keep going until the path takes me somewhere. I wonder if that's where it came from. No, apparently not. That would have taken me upstairs. Nothing here from the looks of it, except for just... this one door. Seems like a more standard dungeon crawl at this point. Okay, we find ourselves in some other... Okay, there's like a fire to each other there. Doesn't make sense to me. That's an Etronach. So this is what I'm talking about. These spells that I'm using. Flesh Etronach. Fire Etronach, just not as bright. There's also the skull here. I don't know whether I should touch this or not. It did something. I don't know what it did, but it did something. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. So many skulls, man. More. But I wonder why they just eat Runak here. I wonder if I should touch. Probably should not go about touching random skulls. Can I rest here? Of course I can't. Just to keep my health topped up, but apparently that's too much to ask for. Warlock's ring, let's just put it on. For the heck of it. Yeah, right here. This skull is facing the other way around. Oh, hey, this like some sort of interactable character right there. Maybe that's where I was supposed to go? Something happened. So, this sword is the Ebony Saber of Oblivion, and while it's not as powerful as the Daedric Katana, it is powerful in the sense that it can potentially kill you instantly. Okay, that door is also barred. Let's try the other way then. This thing just keeps spinning. Oh no! Two fire daydrots. Three fire daydrots. This. Oh! Okay, that's like a shortcut that we can use. That's nice. That is really nice. Sometimes the game just bugs out like that. Still backstabbing and long lead. I would say that's a good outcome, all in all. Let's go this way. Now, this is the Ebony Saber of Oblivion, and one of the things about the Saber of Oblivion is that, well, anything of Oblivion essentially, once you use it, it uses this spell called Sphere of Negation, and what that spell does is it does this nasty little effect wherein no matter who it is that is in front of you, you swing it, there's a chance that it'll instantly kill them. Which is what makes the saber just super overpowered, and magic in general actually. Magic in general in Daggerfall is completely overpowered. No comparison whatsoever. Now this path is actually far more bereft of enemies than the other one, which is quite strange. I thought I saw like a... There's another fire daydrot there nonetheless. Let me just slay you first. And there seems to be this gentleman here. Nothing of value. He does not seem to be hostile. Most likely we talk to him. Ah, at last. I was beginning to think that you wouldn't get this far. A dreary place, don't you agree? And guarded by a pompous upstart. He's no more a god than I am. Well, carry on. We will meet again soon, unless you are not as foolhardy as you appear. Okay. So what am I supposed to do again? Maybe we touch all those skulls and see what's up? I mean, that's the only thing I can think of at this point. Yeah, he doesn't really say much, he just repeats the same thing over and over again. Okay, let's try touching all these skulls then. Curious gentleman though. Very curious gentleman. Is that room open now? I doubt it would be, but I'm pretty sure we have to touch the skulls then. Let's try touching each of these skulls and seeing what they do. It's like a room of embers here. Before I touch this, I would of course like to save in the emergency slot. Am I like too far from it? It just damaged me, of course. So not this skull. It's like whenever you're about to touch something in this game, you better save. It teleported me to on top of this skull here. How nice of you. This one also seems to be more or less useless. Well, I suppose we can try touching the skulls further down the line then. Lots of skulls to touch here. It brought me back here. I think that's the sound of the fire deodorant. Hear me. The blind god is a jealous god. Let his true servants lift up their eyes unto him, and the way will be easy. Hear me. Okay. And is this thing just gonna keep spinning? Alright. The blind god. I wonder who the blind god is. Somebody's chucking spells at me. Oh, it's you. You know what? You... Fine. I'll save here again. Something happened. Now... I'm not sure whether we've touched this yet or not, but... I think we have, yes, we have touched this. It just transports us back to that place. So these two skulls here seem to spin. This one apparently also spins. So wait, are we supposed to touch them again so that they stop spinning at the appropriate time? Ooh, the... Yeah. Really, son? I need to get rid of that Daedrot, fire Daedrot. Okay, this is gonna happen here. I'm gonna change. My luck is low. I wonder why my luck is afflicted of all things. Good. And yeah. Left hand equipped, right hand equipped. And I just wanna check something. I'm healthy, so why is my luck so afflicted? Yeah. It just teleports me to the top of this skull here. Of course. There you are. It's strange, like sometimes the ranged attacks don't work at all in this game, and sometimes they're like the only things that work. I'm fortified, so let me just put on my sword and shield again. Magic items, the other sword, not this one. Really? There's one more of you? But there should be another one of you then. Holy shit, there's like an entire army down here. No way am I gonna go for that. So I cannot touch this anymore. This one also does something, it also like makes a sound and starts spinning. This one just teleports me elsewhere. This one hurts me. No, this one teleports me. This one I think hurts me. And I don't think there are any more skulls here. Let's see if that opens something up. Or whether there are any more skulls that need to be touched. That's still locked. What about this one? That is also still locked, so I'm guessing we have to touch more spells then. The blind god. I can't remember when I first came across that phrase. That thing is gleefully spinning. This was a tight turn, so I had to slow down a little. This thing stopped turning though. This thing also makes a sound when it spins. Probably should have saved before I did that. This also does the same. This one also does the same. This one just teleports me onto the ground, presumably. So we're not gonna touch this one. I wonder if I have to touch all the spells or just a few of them work. That did something. I don't know what it did, but that did something. It also made like a moaning sound. Didn't I take care of you already? Curious. I thought I killed that one already. Is there like one on top? No, I don't think there is. No! Alright, that was my mistake. Yeah, there's another one of these fire atronachs, who looks more like a flesh atronach, to be honest. It's like this level is just spawning enemies randomly at this point. Every time I get teleported or load up a save. And yeah, I think that's the end of all the skulls here. But everything is still locked. So what do they exactly mean by true? Followers. Okay, this thing is a face, so unless this is supposed to be the blind god, I suppose we are supposed to only activate the skulls that are looking right at it. Because it's said that the blind god is a jealous god. So it doesn't want folks who don't look at it to, you know. This is spinning now, but it apparently stops spinning after a while. We can't make it stop spinning though, and that's the thing. I wonder if we just need to wait here until it stops spinning. At least the lighting is on point. This one was by default looking away, so I guess this is not the one. This skull is also looking away, so I'm guessing that is not a true follower. This one, however, is, I think, looking at the face. Right. This one is looking away. This one is also looking away. Hear me, the blind god is a jealous god. Let his true servants lift up their eyes unto him, and the way will be easy. Hear me. I mean, this thing here is looking at the god, so maybe it is a true servant. That thing is looking away from the god, so maybe we do not want to activate that. Maybe it's a time-based thing, who knows. Like, we just need to be quick as all. Like, while the skulls are still spinning, we can make it in here. Nope, it's all still locked. Curious. I wonder if the skulls that we spin eventually stop spinning, or whether they keep spinning. Like, these skulls are definitely looking away, so unless my logic was wrong. This skull is also apparently looking away, so we don't really need to spin that skull. But this skull, we did spin this, didn't we? I guess it is a matter of speed. Like, if we are quick enough, then maybe we can make it. I'm trying to focus on the road so that I don't fall off. Nope. Still not the case. There are two bars here now. Okay, wait, there are changes that are occurring to it. You probably won't be helping us. I am totally lost at this point. This one damages me. This one teleports me somewhere, so these are just decoy skulls. Okay, this teleports me as well. That's good, that's good. Okay, you guys need to fuck off. Save was a spell made, but I'll probably be dying to fall damage. Okay, so where were we again? Right, we're going up this, I think. Thank you. Does this make any changes? I can only wonder. The thing is, unless and until I get close to the damn thing, I will not be able to figure out whether it is making any changes or not. Because I could have sworn the first time around that I saw the place, it only had like... Yeah, now it has got like two bars. The first time around it only had like one bar. Is it this one? Nope, that just adds a bar. Like, that makes no change to it. Unless it changes the other side. This puzzle is pretty cryptic. I mean, to be honest, all the puzzles in this game are very cryptic. No, it still has two bars. Since I'm too lazy to get back up there, like get back down there. That did nothing. It just makes a like a sound, like the same sound that you get when a zombie's moaning. Not the one we should have gone to. Not the one we should have clicked on. Okay. I should probably just keep using that warlock's ring. Since it protects me from spells, instantly reflects all spells, and the whole host of Pyodatra down there are sort of beginning to be a problem. Come on. Did that do anything? And when I say do anything, I mean did that like... open up one of the eyes? No, it still has like... two entire... bars there. Near the eyes. So that mirror does nothing. So, sorry, that skull does nothing. This skull does nothing. So I think... we just touched this one, it did nothing. Maybe this one will do something? Let us go and check then. From the looks of it, only one skull can rotate at a time. Is it that we just need to rotate the skull and go touch another skull until... and time it so that all the skulls are looking at this, at the piece in the center. Okay, that got rid of one of those bars. So that skull does something. We should probably keep it this way. The one nearest to the entrance, I mean. Almost nearest to the entrance. This one, right here, the one that's rotating in front of us. Warlock's ring. Did we touch this girl? I don't recall, actually. Should I just save you? Yeah, let's touch this and try going back just to see what's going on. If that actually unlocked everything. I don't think it will, but yeah. Right now one of them is looking at the skull in the center. Okay, no change. I wonder if it isn't just a game of making the skulls look at the skull in the middle. Like, if there are at least like two skulls looking at it, then problem solved. Now I'm gonna go back up the other side and check if this did anything. If not, then we're gonna have to come back and... Well, I don't think this would add any bars, to be honest. Or maybe it could, to be true. We saw that the nearest skull dropped us a bar. But there's still only one bar here. I'm gonna take it from the entrance onwards. And let's see. A lot of traveling back and forth in this level. So that was the first skull. This is the second skull. I don't think this does anything. Like, I think it's one of the skulls that spins. I kept forgetting to save the... Let's see if this unlocked anything. Oh yeah, it did unlock everything. Okay, I guess we just... Maybe we can rest here. Yeah, I'm not engaging you. As long as you're not aware of me, I'm not engaging you. There's this thing in the middle, and it just went down for whatever reason. I'm just gonna save in the emergency slot here because I want to do two things. One is touch this, and more skulls here, to be honest, which don't really do anything. A helm, a shield. A lot of times, like, Daedric artifacts typically look like this stuff. It's going somewhere. Can I please go? Okay, there's like this huge skull here in the middle. Excuse me. One speaks for me, two serve me, six protect me. How many defy me? Okay, this is an arena-style riddle here. I wonder if all of this was supposed to be just like how the rest of the game was supposed to be, but they just couldn't manage to fit in all the riddles. Because this is one of the factors about arena that I miss in this game. These stupid riddles. One speaks for me, two serve me, six protect me, how many defy me? Now, if six are protecting you, they probably wouldn't be defying you. Two serve you, so of course they can't defy you if they're already serving you. One speaks for me. Now, typically somebody else speaking for you would be considered defiance, because, yeah, it's like they're putting words into your mouth. So I suppose it's one. I suppose that was the correct answer. And lots of skulls here. Let me save here. Excuse me again. I don't think I've ever heard such a thing. Oh, okay, I see what's going on here. we basically need to use any of these magical skulls to unlock the store here. That did nothing. That took us back out. Right. Emergency? Yeah, I think it was the emergency slot. Process of elimination. That's all it is. That just made a noise. What about that one? Oh, okay. You're just an Iron Age Renac. That's all you are. I got scared for no reason. Funny thing is, I couldn't get into that place without booing, or rather crouching, which is quite strange in my book. A flesh Atronach, I sort of confused you for a zombie there. Iron Atronach all over the place. Probably should have saved before you touched it, but oh well. Giant's heads here, all over the place. Lots of flags and banners all over the place. But yeah, this entire section is quite... I would say it's very off-putting in a way. That's a sphere of negation taking effect. Am I moving in a loop here? No. I sort of got concerned there for a second. Am I moving in a loop here? Flesh Atronach died. I hope I don't have to touch any of these torches. Iron Atronach. Okay. Saving my progress, and this is the only door apparently that I can touch or open, like the only route here, unless there were some hidden doors there. Does not seem to be the case though. This is the only door. Okay, that is strange. I wonder why this is here. That's like a suit of armor. Creepy. Another suit of armor. Let me guess, another suit of armor. Yeah, I better keep saving here. Because this place is full of riddles. Oh, that's a rogue. Successful backstab, but Archer did not die with the first hit, primarily because it was an ebony blade and not anything else. I wonder what humans are doing in this area. Knights and rogues of everything. Maybe it's like a space where the space-time, like a place where the space-time continuum is all bent. But there's like a path upwards and there's like a path downwards. One of them would require me to have like a spell of levitation. Because I can't climb this wall. I could try though. I don't know how it's gonna go, but let me try going upstairs. Let's see if it is at all useful. Like, the best chance you have of a new stand of climbing anywhere is to essentially... Nope. Not happening. Downstairs we go then. That is... Should I just... Nah. Okay, we saw places. This guy fell down apparently and we... Okay, there's like another one of these elevator shafts here. Okay, we got up this one. But that one is still a mystery. Seems to be an elevator shaft, to be honest. That thing over there. Okay, so this is where we were going to come down anyway. And there's like this elevator shaft up there. Unless we can touch it, which we apparently cannot. Alright, let's jump down then. And step onto the elevator instead. Like we were meant to. Okay, it's... Excuse me, I just arrived here. Magic items, please. Yes. First of all, I need to use this, and second, I need to use this. But yeah, there's like this thing right here, and lots of enemies just surrounding me all over this. A voice laughs at me. Saying something? Did I just get teleported again? Yes, I think I did. My spell was reflected. Ooh, that was close. Now to jump onto the crossbow itself. Excuse me. Thank you for your patronage. But now for me to jump onto the crossbow is the main hit issue here. Let's save here. Somebody has been constantly hitting me with spells. And okay, so at this point, I'm just gonna... Where do I save? I guess we don't need the save anymore. Maybe I'm... Suppose... Let's try doing it from here. What that... Oh, okay, we are saved this time around. Oh, alright. I guess that was the reason why that wasn't working out for us. Okay, so... What now? Let me just go ahead and put on the shade, the protector, and the warlock string as well. Use it right here. And should we save the game here then? I suppose. Let's see where this takes us. I think all the way to the top. Yes, it does unlock the room as well. So I suppose it is doable with the... without magic for the most part. It's just very poorly designed. Not fit to handle any of the, you know, any of the platforming. I wouldn't exactly call it poorly designed, just 3D platformers have always been clunky, and well, this game is no exception, is what I would say. I can hear something there, and it's glowing, so I might as well pop in a potion of resist fire. And just for good measure, a potion of resist shock as well. Because I have a lot of all of this stuff. Resist shock, I'm looking for resist shock. Good to see that I still have my potion of levitation, should I need it later on? Shadow form, resist shock, I'm out of resist shock. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I'm out of resist shock. Yeah, I don't recall using up one final. You know what, let's just save it. I don't want to use it right now. That's a coast. That's a fire dodger. Good thing we pre-popped that potion there. There's like a campfire and everything in this room in case you want the rest. We have everything prepared. Don't you worry. Like all of these... Of course. All of these rooms are interconnected for the most part. Tall boots? Where did it go? Tall boots of unrestrainable tall boots, right? I was searching for tall boots and not unrestrainable tall boots. That was my bad. Okay. Back up, please. And we fell down again. I hear a vampire ancient. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save the game here. And I'm gonna pop in the potion of resist shock. Because I don't wanna tussle with one of them. Vampire ancients. Now where was it? Potion of resist shock. It was somewhere here. Resist shock. Resist shock. Resist shock. Water breathing. Frost. 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 Water walking. Frost. Action. Fire. Poison. Form. Poison, poison, falling, poison, water walking, resist poison. Why do I have so many potions of resist poison? Cure poison, cure disease, resist shock. Okay. Hey, that's a green jewel there. You know what? Let's just do this. Let's just use the potion of levitation and get there. But before I do, I just want to update this here save. And... Nah, emergency slot. Potion of levitation. Levitation right here. And I'm gonna save you. Right here. Is it gonna trigger the ending cutscene? Nulfaga cackles. Not so fast, Grimfangs. Don't you want to see the result of your handiwork? Look now into the Book of the Time. Read upon its passages the history of what shall pass within the next few days. Read fate as it shall be recorded upon the Elder Scrolls.
Great Numidium, its raw power tempered only by the blaze, crushes all of the rebellious children of the Empire, destroying their armies.
Your work is done, Grimfangs. The world is no longer as it once was. Such is the way of things. Oh, and if you tell my lit statue to shut up, the door to my chamber will open. Right. So basically... Alright, I'm still levitating. I forgot. So, basically whenever I have to play some cutscene in this game, I have to like run the CPU cycles all the way down to like... why is everything white? Strange. Did it like recently snow here? And why am I so far away from Castle Shedungent now? Interesting. So anyway, every time I need to record a movie, it essentially... Wrothgarian Mountains, Coatria, Cambria, everything still seems the same way that it was. I don't know what changed, to be honest. Yeah, I need to make sure that the CPU cycles set for DOSBox are 5,000 at most, otherwise the cutscene starts stuttering. So yeah, I sort of had to do that. And yeah, that was that. Sort of anticlimactic, but I suppose giving the Totem of Tiber Septim to... what's his name? Uriel Septim VII was also a mistake, because he just went on a rampage with it, just the same as any other king would have done. Be it... what's his name? King Gothred, or King Edvir, or Queen Akorithi. Or not Akorithi, Obuki. And yeah, nothing really changed. Nothing was really different. So, that's sort of sad. Anyhow, that was it for today's video. And this is practically the finale of The Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. I mean, there's nothing more to the story after this. Just like a sort of anticlimactic ending. But I suppose the real treasure and the real story was the memories we made along the way, huh? So, yeah. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. The final dungeon, though, was pretty cryptic, I felt like. But Daedric is improved. That is something else altogether. So, yeah, I mean, it was the end. Ending was pretty cryptic. I did not expect the final dungeon to be as cryptic, but it was a weird kind of treat. They certainly got the atmosphere down very well. A lot of the areas were very, how do I put it, intense, and a lot of the areas were at the same time very vivid, very weirdly vivid. So extremely different, like a completely different vibe to it, and it had like a very strong emphasis on the puzzles, although figuring out what the puzzles were in most cases was a puzzle in itself. So I would say, if anything, that is something that that is some place where the developers sort of went overboard with all of the puzzles, and yeah, pretty much that. Apart from that, I can't really remark a lot upon what just happened. It's just like a sort of like a series of puzzles one after the other, and a series of dungeons, and at the end of it all, we didn't really get much either. It was like a very short ending. The Empire enslaved everybody. End of story. Like, here's to hoping that things would be better, but yeah, it's just hope. What else can we do, right? Anyway, the reason that I'm here in front of Fighters Guild is because I realized that I do not exactly have the Comp USA edition, and I just added a patch which gives me those quests. Now, the thing is, Fighters Guild has this infamous questline, which is called the Lord Kavar questline, and the fact that I did not play it as a member of the Fighters Guild, it was sort of bugging me. So, as one final video after the main, you know, quest is over, what I want to do is, I essentially want to cover that quest. And to that end, that is what you can expect to see when we get back next time. Until then, thank you for watching, thank you for tuning in, and thank you for sticking around until the end, not only of this entire series, but also of this, you know, this specific video. So, yeah, sincerely, thank you for that. This game, all in all, Daggerfall was very... It was unique. The stories in this game were very politically intriguing. And it had like a very thriller sort of vibe to the plotline. However, by the end, it just all goes to... I don't know. Maybe they could have handled the execution of the finale a little better, then it might have been a little more profound and impactful. but as it stands right now, it just doesn't gel well, if you know what I'm saying. So, yeah. Anyhow, this is it for today. Until we meet again for the Lord Kavar quests. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.